This video will explain the procedure of the ASTM C39 to find the compressive strength of a concrete cylinder. There are two kinds of cylinders that can be tested. 1. Cast-in-place cylinder in the laboratory. Or 2. A drilled cylindrical core taken out from any civil engineering structure. To perform this test, the equipment that should be required is: First, a machine that is power operated and capable of applying pressure at a constant rate. Length measuring device like a vernier caliper or a measuring tape. And unbonding capping pads. Other equipment that might be required is a weighing machine. Now, let's get to the procedure. ASTM suggests that the specimen should be tested at the following ages: 24 hours, 3 days, 7 days, 28 days, or 90 days with tolerances as shown. Note the diameter of the specimen. Apply the sulfur or gypsum capping as per ASTM C17 or neoprene pads as per ASTM 1231 with capping metal retainers to the top and the bottom of the specimen. Note that neoprene pads should be flipped after 50 tests and replaced after 100 tests. Place the specimen at the center of the machine. Start applying the continuous load at the rate of 0.25 MPa per second without any shock. Wait for the sample to crack. Note the loading at which the sample cracked, also known as failure load. And we are done with physical testing. Let's go to the calculation. First, calculate the area of the specimen by using the formula: pi multiplied by the radius of the specimen squared. Dividing the failure load by this calculated area gives us the strength of the specimen. Now, let's prepare a professional-looking report. This report should include the diameter of the specimen, the age of the specimen, the failure load, the strength of the specimen, and a mode of failure, which can be chosen out of 6 given by the ASTM standard based on crack pattern shown here. Optionally, the client might also require you to report the area of this specimen, the volume of the specimen, weight and density, which comes by dividing mass by the volume of the specimen. It is better to attach a photo of specimen for the future reference. If there are more than one specimen, then the strengths from each specimen are averaged to give mean strength of concrete. Also, each specimen is given its unique name or identity. Hope you find this helpful. Please comment below if you want any other ASTM or other standard video to be made. Subscribe to our channel for other videos like this. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.